Hi, this is Shari from Little Blue Deer, and today I'm going to show you how to make a really cool pop-out off-canvas menu in Elementor. So it's very easy. There's lots of different plugins for it, but I like it if I don't have to use a plugin. So you can see from my menu, I've got my site title, I've got a little gallery, and then I've got my WordPress menu. Pop out search box, which is an Elementor feature, and then my social media icons. So, very easy to do. And all you have to do is go to your dashboard to start. So, and you're going to go scroll down to Elementor templates, and then you're going to go to pop-ups. And I've already created my pop-up. You can import templates here, but you can also go to add a new pop-up and you can choose your template type here. But I've already created mine. They're very easy to create. If you have Elementor Pro, you'll see a bunch of different ones. I'm going to show you how to sort of set it up and then link it up. So the pop-up that I have is called the side menu. And I'm going to go to edit with Elementor, and then you can see it here. So basically, this is just a side Elementor pop-out. I had added my site title here as my image, and I've linked it to my site URL. I added a gallery. You could add a single image, you could add a logo, whatever really you want. But this is just a simple Elementor gallery. And then I'd added the start here text, which is just the text editor. Now, most of your side pop-out menus, you will want to use a WordPress menu. So you can see here, I've added my menu. And so if you're starting this out, you would just want to go to the plus sign here, and then you can just search menu, and you'll see the WordPress menu option. And then you can display your menu. As you can see, the style, you want it to be vertical. All right, so you can see here that now it's vertical, so it'll show up on this canvas. The other options are drop down, but you don't really want, I think, to use a menu within a menu. So I have set mine to vertical. And you can, of course, take care of all the styling by clicking on the typography pencil. You can change your font style. You can also do things on the menu. I'm going to go ahead and delete this menu. You can also do things on the menu, like adjust the space between to make it larger or smaller. So you can see the larger I make it, the more it fills up the space. I don't want my menu to be too long, so I'm actually going to leave it at 0 here. And then you can also add the search form. So if you're wanting to add this, you just Google or search form, and you just drag it over. And you can either leave it like this as the full search menu, or you could also do the you can change it to text. You can use the style, the classic minimal that has no background on the search magnifying glass, or you can do the full screen, which is what I like. So if you do the full screen, it'll have the cool full screen Elementor pop out, and you can align it here. So I've already done that as well. And then down here at the bottom, of course, the social icons are always nice to add. So, I've got my menu set up. Once again, I have gone to Dashboard, Elementor, Pop-outs, and then I've picked my pop-out and I've styled it here. So now I have it, but it's not connected to anything. So I'm not going to add a condition. I'm just going to go to Save and Close, and then I'm going to exit out back to my site. And you'll see that now I have in my menu, which has my site logo and menu, when I click on it, there's the pop-up that I created. All right, so how do I get from being able to click on this menu to actually making it make the menu pop-up. That's what I'm going to show you next and last. So I want to go to Edit with Elementor, and I want to go to my header. I'm assuming you already have a header created. So click on Header, and when it loads, you'll see here's my menu. Now, you could also, I had before, but I decided I wanted the text. You could also use the three-bar icon for this. That's sort of the universal signifier of a menu. I wanted menu text, but I will show you if you want to add the three bars. You're going to search icon and just drag the icon over. And then you'll click on the star, which is the default, and type in bars. Okay. And then you'll see the menu bars, and then you'll be able to align it and also to style the size. That looks kind of huge to me. So I could also conceivably use this three-bar icon here. Either way, the most important thing is, how do I link this to my pop-up menu that I created? So I'm going to actually use the menu that I already created. And you'll see in the link, you're going to want to choose custom URL. See, there's the pop-up here. Okay. So I'll use this icon as an example. So I've got my icon. For my link, I'm going to choose custom URL. All right. And then I'm going to go to dynamic tags. And I'm going to click on pop-up. Actions, pop-up, lightbox, contact URL. So we're going to choose pop-up. Now, how do I determine which pop-up to use? After I've selected pop-up, I'm going to click on the wrench. I'm going to choose open pop-up. And then I'm going to click here where it says all, and I've named my menu side menu. Okay, so remember what you named your menu. And you're just going to choose side menu, and that will open the pop-up. All right. And that's all you have to do. I'm going to publish this, and I'm just going to show you as an example, since I linked up that three bar icon menu. Now I have this and I can click on it. I have my accessibility, which is why my menu's highlighted, and I can close it. I also still have my menu. I can click on it, and there's my pop-up that I created. So I'm going to pop back in my header. I'm going to delete the three-bar icon. And keep in mind as well in your header that you can obviously, you could move this to the center, to a different column, etc. But I'm not going to use it at all because right now I'm really just liking the menu text. I'm going to click publish. And that is really all that there is to creating a beautiful pop-out side Canvas menu. And I'll do another tutorial with a full page menu as well. So please keep following along. And if you're interested in custom blog design or custom website or logo design, then please feel free to visit me at littlebluedeerdesign.com. Thanks so much for watching.